Today I've got Dr. Jason Julian, Associate Professor of Geography at Texas State University here with me. Welcome, Jason. You were a Fulbright Scholar in New Zealand in 2012. Can you describe how you became a Fulbright Scholar?
So my dissertation research was focused on water clarity of rivers, and I submitted one of my papers on my dissertation research, and it was reviewed by one of the experts in the field who lives here in New Zealand. And after he reviewed my paper, he invited me to come to New Zealand as an assistant visiting research scientist. And at the time, there was no funding available in New Zealand, so I looked for ways of getting it funded. And Fulbright was one opportunity. And wrote the proposal, submitted it, and in the end, I was fortunate enough to have a great host here who wrote a very convincing recommendation letter. And two of my mentors were also former Fulbright New Zealand alumni. So they also provide some great reference letters, and that's what got me the Fulbright to come to New Zealand.
So how specifically has being a Fulbright scholar benefited you?
So the 3 months I spent here in 2012 were just amazing. I was meeting new people every day from a wide variety of fields and perspectives, politicians, economists, and a variety of scientists. And so it really gave me a lot of diverse perspectives on many aspects of New Zealand, but also on the world as well. But more than anything, I think it was the people I met while I was here. So all these people I met eventually became good friends and collaborators for research. And now I've, with their help, I've now been funded to continue doing my research here in New Zealand. So,
following on from that, can you describe the research you're doing in New Zealand?
Yeah. So in general, I look at how land use changes, climate changes, and water quality changes are related to one another. So in New Zealand, you have a small country that's very dynamic in terms of its climate, land use, vegetation. And because they're so dynamic, they're interacting in ways that we don't see in other parts of the world. So it's a great place to look at all these changes going on. And specifically, we're looking at land cover changes at very fine resolution. So every 8 days at 30 meters, and what impacts that potentially has on water quality.
Right. Oh, that's absolutely fascinating. And how will this research benefit New Zealand?
Yeah, so New Zealand's in a very interesting place where they're becoming global players in the economic markets. But along with that comes these intense land use changes. And some of the land uses, whether it's livestock grazing or forest harvesting, is being increased and being intensified in New Zealand. So I think our work will show the connections between that land use change, climate, and then ultimately water quality, which is one of New Zealand's greatest resources.
Thank you. And this is now your second trip to New Zealand. Do you see yourself returning to New Zealand again in the future?
Yeah, so again, I've been fortunate to meet a lot of people, and I've also been fortunate to get funded to do these research projects from the U.S. So NASA has funded some of this project, and now we'll be getting some funding from National Science Foundation. And in the long term, yeah, New Zealand will be sort of my second home professionally. So probably every 2 to 3 years, I'll be returning.
Oh, that sounds fantastic. Well, thank you very much, Jason. That's been great.
All right, thanks.